graduates here for the 2023 graduating class of the Robert Trude Academy. Please be seated. What a special day. It may be drizzling outside, Sister June, but the sun is shining on these talented young men and women, and to every family member, every friend, every team member, part of the Robert Trude Academy family. It's a great day in Newark, and it's a great day for the Robert Trude Academy. This is the 19th graduation ceremony, 19 times. I know my dad, Steve Adubato Sr., is making sure that we start on time, making sure the program goes as it should, and could not be more proud of the young men and women who are on this altar, and to the staff and the teachers and the team at the Robert Trude Academy. So Mom, I know that at least this one day, Steve Sr. is happy. So I wanna kick things off by hearing from the first of several of the really talented, special students at the Robert Trude Academy. Let me tell you a little bit about India Hilton. Anyone know India Hilton? Put your hands together for India Hilton. India, where are you? Just put your hand up, India. Where's India? India, I was exhausted reading this. Just stand there. Listen to this. India is going to lead us. She's the salutatorian of the salutatorian. That's a big deal. You're gonna get tired of applauding because listen to this. She's graduating with a 4.5 grade point average. That's Teresa, that's out of four? That's out of four, not five. I have no idea what that stands for. 4.5, that's, oh, okay. This young lady has been involved in the Robert Trude Academy variety of clubs since day one. Listen to this, vice president of the Student Council, National Junior Honor Society, the Yearbook Club, Stand and Deliver, peer tutoring. She plays the clarinet in the school band, and as a team captain of the girls, basketball team, India is a recipient of the Young Writers Award and Principal's List Award, all four cycles. Now, outside of the Robert Trude Academy, India plays guitar, engages in graphic design, plays softball, and is part of AAU basketball. But what India really loves and is most exciting to her are her basketball skills and talents. In high school at Newark Academy, let's hear for Newark Academy. At Newark Academy, India plans to expand her love of computers and software development and pursue a career in computer science. Now, although she currently plays the acoustic guitar, always ambitious, taking on new challenges, she plans to take on the electric guitar. I am absolutely exhausted just introducing our salutatorian for the Pledge of Allegiance here. Let's hear it for India Hilton.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready, salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
One more time for India Hill. Here they come. For a very special rendition of the national anthem, please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, performing the national anthem, the Robert Trude Academy Chorus. That is the Robert Treat Academy chorus. One more time. Please be seated. So this is the principal's address, Mr. Trill, is that right? So, Mr. Trillo is a certain kind of leader. I'm a student of leadership, and I can see you're a certain kind of leader. You're passionate, you care deeply. Now, you do not cry the way my sister Teresa does. I can get you to cry right now, easily. Just think about our childhood. No, I'm joking. Ma, I'm sorry. It was Sister June, hold her hand, please. But she just sees these graduates coming up. I was watching her. Very emotional. Your emotions are just as strong. They just come out differently. I don't know whether you're going to cry during the principal's address, but I know you care deeply about these young men and women and their futures, their bright futures. And so please join me to deliver the principal's address, our principal of the Robert Cheatham Academy, Marcelino Trillo.
Good morning, everybody. Everyone feeling good? You guys doing good up there? Right, not much longer, then no one's gonna celebrate you for another 4 years. All right, so enjoy today. Okay, thank you for the introduction, Steve. I always appreciate any joke that involves anyone in the Adubato family. So that's always good. Special and sincere thanks to all of the dignitaries that could take time out of their undoubtedly hectic schedules to be with us today. I hope you enjoy the ceremony and take pride in being a part of the extended RTA family. We truly appreciate your support and friendship. As you know well, it's a very special family to be a part of. Another special gesture of appreciation to our founding organization, without whom any of this would be possible. The Northward Center was the entity that enabled Big Steve to bring his vision for a strong family-oriented community to life. We are honored to continue to carry out his mission of elevating our community through RTA and privileged to enjoy the continued support and partnership of the Northward Center under the leadership of their CEO and my friend, Michelle Adubato. Thank you, Michelle. Now on to you guys. It's about you today. The class of 2023, what an adventure you must have had these past 9 years. Some things are better left untold. Most of you started at RTA in August of 2014. Those of you that joined later on quickly became a part of this special group of students who lived through the pandemic during a critical time in your development. Despite that incredible challenge, you have made it here today. Give yourselves a hand. While being here today, ready to receive your diplomas from RTA is a testament to your hard work and resiliency. I am sure you realize this is the end of one journey, but the beginning of the rest of your life, right? Every day is the first day of the rest of your life. With this in mind, I'd like to give you a few tasks to complete today and a bit of advice for the future. So humor me. Here we go. Task number one. Before this day ends, tell someone in your family you love them and explain why. It could be a parent, an auntie, abuelito, a sibling, or a cousin who has been there for you when you needed to be loved or supported, or maybe even put in your place, because we all have to be put in our place sometimes. Understand that this person has seen you through good times and bad and has provided you with the support you needed to make it here today. It doesn't have to be a parent necessarily, but remember, someone in your family has your back, and you should be generous with your expressions of appreciation. That being said, why don't we start by giving your parents and families who are gathered here today a big round of applause. All right, task number two is not just for today, but before you start high school, thank a teacher, a coach, a mentor, a counselor, a priest, somebody that you had a special relationship with outside of your family. Maybe they helped teach you something you didn't think you'd ever figure out, or boosted your confidence, or motivated you to put your best foot forward. Your support network is nearly as important as your family, only they don't have to love you or help you, they choose to. With this in mind, how's about a hand for the teachers and staff at the Academy who have watched you grow into the young men and women you are today? All right, last task, and then I just have a little advice. So task number three, soak it all in. Appreciate what you've done and how far you've come. Remember the past, but don't let previous failures or embarrassments keep you from trying again. Learn from it, but let it go. Think about the future and set lofty goals, but don't let it distract you from the great things happening right in front of you right now. Be engaged in whatever you are doing, because every new day is a gift. That's why it's called the present. All right, that's it for your task. No more jobs for you today. But I ask that you humor me a little bit longer and listen to some advice from me one last time. Three important things that I try to keep in mind as I've grown older, still not as old as Teresa, but older, that I think I can help you as long as you go through this impending next important stage in your life. Number one, always, always, always remember where you come from. You are just a kid from Newark who may go on to do great things. Be proud of your roots, your city, your neighborhood, your school, and your culture and traditions. They define you. Without your experiences, you wouldn't become who you are destined to be. Never apologize for where you've been, because all those experiences are leading you to where you are going. If you ever find yourself in a situation where you can choose to be right or be kind, choose kindness. Winning isn't everything. You are the only one who may remember that you were right about an argument, but everyone who meets you and spends any time with you will always remember how you made them feel and how you treated them. Leave a good impression. Finally, help people. Get involved. Find a cause bigger than yourself and let it feed your spirit. Make even a small difference in your immediate community by coaching, mentoring, or volunteering to serve those in need. It will fill your heart and give you great perspective on life and appreciation for how very lucky you are. You are all very lucky to have the opportunities you have been presented with. Know that and believe that. And of course, last but not least, I would be remiss if I didn't end with the best advice that we've been trying to brainwash you with for these last 9 years. Work hard, be the best that you can be kind to one another, and make good choices. Thank you for being such an amazing group of young people, and please know that although you graduate today, you will always be part of the RTA family.
You know, Mr. Trillo said it's important to remember where you come from. For those of us born and raised in this neighborhood, that's impossible to do. It's in our DNA. It's who we are. We carry it with us. And it's Newark grit, Brick City grit. And let's hear it for Newark and Brick City. So, regardless of where you go and the things you accomplish in life, being from this neighborhood matters. And one person who understands that better than most, I'm about to introduce you to. I was actually doing a program the other day on the need to create more diversity in government. And there was a leader in the Latina community who said that we are losing black and brown leaders in the legislature and we need more Latinas. And I said, well, what do we need to do? And this leader said, we need to look at role models like the Senate Majority Leader, Teresa Ruiz, who embodies everything about this community, about this school, and about trying to make a difference, particularly when it comes to education. Please welcome for very special remarks the New Jersey Senate Majority Leader, Senator Teresa Ruiz.
Good morning, everyone. Buenos dias. Bonjour, and that's all I have. To the graduating class of 2023, Principal Trillo said it the best, but I also want to add to that. You should be proud. You should be filled with love. You should be filled with hope and with faith about the endless opportunities that will await you for the rest of your lifetime. But know that with all of that, there are going to be hiccups and obstacles. Don't let a look from someone who doesn't know what's in the core of your soul define you. Don't let someone who, when they hear for the first time that you come from the city of Newark, pass judgment onto you, one that you know that is not filled with truth. Don't let an opportunity of when you fall publicly, because that's the best, and I want to really focus on that. When you fall publicly, the best opportunity you will have is to show with dignity and grace how you get up. And if you have really good shoes on, then it's an epic moment even better. Understand that you didn't come to this day alone, that it was filled with the love, the tenacity, and the encouragement of your family that's sitting here today supporting you, by wonderful administrators at both campuses, by teachers who really help raise all of you. You spend more time with classroom leaders than you do with our own families. I have a 6-year-old, and I know this to be truth, that a teacher becomes part of the extended family. So remember those moments that that extended family fed into you so that you can give back. And for some of you who are gonna go far, far away, my heart breaks for all those mothers who will drop you off on those days. But understand that when you feel alone, that when you feel lost, that maybe you're the only one who looks like you in those spaces, that you have a crowd of amazing people in Newark supporting you, encouraging you, praying for you, lifting you up, because we want you to come back to this great city and to serve in so many different capacities. And so I will close with this. Like I tell my daughter every morning, use your voice. Be a queen. Be a king. Be kind. Be respectful. And know that every chance you get to lean into a space that makes you uncomfortable is an opportunity to lift up a moment for others that will create comfort for so many.
Para todas las familias que se encuentran aquí hoy, estoy orgullosa a compartir con todos ustedes, llena de amor y de alegría y de fe, a ver lo que va a lograr nuestra juventud en los próximos 4 años.
So I still have some time to be here in a very personal capacity, and I'm like Teresa. I get sad. I'm a mother. All the mothers, you know, we get like this because I love to see kids grow. I remember at Robert Treat Academy, I grew up literally a half a block away from the school. And when I was growing up, there wasn't a school building there. It was a community garden. And I will tell you that the best garden that you have ever seen there is the actual brick and mortar of Robert Treat Academy, because the fruits of the labor that have been poured into that institution will give back over and over for decades to come. Congratulations to everyone.
All right, thank you for those wonderful words from our friend, Senator Teresa Ruiz. It is now time for the chorus to come on and join us again and entertain us. We have Mr. Rejoui leading our chorus, and we are featuring some soloists, along with Mr. Commanda, Angel Fuentes, Yaritza Menjivar, Ariana Ortega, and Nyla Van Dyke for our musical interlude, The Climb by Miley Cyrus. Let's hear it again. Keep it going for the Robert Reed Academy Choir. All right, as the chorus exits the stage, it's my privilege to introduce our keynote speaker this year. And if you've looked at the program, you know our keynote speaker is Sister June Favada, president of St. Vincent Academy. She served at this gem of a Newark school, the only private secondary school for young women in Newark, for 54 plus years. She began at SBA as an English teacher in 1969 and assumed a leadership role in 1976. Most recently, Sister June was named president of the Academy and member of the newly formed Board of Trustees. Sister June is a lifelong New Jersey resident and a Sister of Charity of St. Elizabeth for 62 years. Sister June holds a Bachelor of Arts degree in English from the College of St. Elizabeth and a Master of Arts in Communication Arts from the University of Notre Dame. An accomplished photographer, Sister June interrupted her service at SVA for 2 years in the 70s to serve as Director of Communications for the Sisters of Charity. Earlier, she taught English at St. Patrick High School in Elizabeth and St. Mary High School in Jersey City. She began her teaching career as an eighth grade teacher at St. Teresa School in Summit, New Jersey. Sister June has been honored and recognized, receiving many awards for her service throughout the community. She is most proud, however, of the students of SVA and of the Sisters of Charity of St. Elizabeth, who never faltered in their commitment to the Academy. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a great friend of the Academy, the president of the Great St. Vincent, Sister June Favada.
Thank you so much. Thank you for that very beautiful introduction. I just want you to know that I was only two when I started all of this. I just want to say first, because I feel this deeply, it is good for us to be here. It is good for us to be here. I'd like to greet Fran Adubato, whose husband, and I know she did it with him, is the founder of the RTA Academy, RTA, and the other Adubatos who are here today, who have collectively and individually contributed so much to Newark, so much to you, to your neighborhoods. To this city would be a different place without that family. And I feel privileged to have known them. In particular, I've known Fran and Steve and Teresa, and sometimes young Steve on and off, but those other three are the ones that I knew very well. And I felt very proud to know them, and I felt very good to see the good that they were doing. St. Vincent Academy has had a very close relationship with RTA since its founding. And I think it's because our missions are so closely tied together. We care about young people. We care about what's their growth and development. We care that they will begin to grow in an understanding of who they are, of what they can contribute, of how much Newark needs them, needs their talents, needs their commitment. It's extremely important, class. I didn't greet you because I saved you. Well, I didn't save you to last, because I wanted to greet the parents and families and friends who are here. You deserve to take a very big bow, because they would not be there if you were not here. And so I believe I honestly believe that today is a day of celebration. It is a day of recognizing these young people, what they've achieved, not only what they achieved, but what they can do as they move on in their lives. But you know what? it has to be a day of gratitude. I hope, I pray, that along with the excitement that you're feeling, excitement that you never felt in exactly the same way before, I hope your heart is filled with gratitude to your parents and relatives and friends, and most especially to your teachers, your coaches. These people who have poured their love into you every day, regardless of how you received it or didn't receive it. It never changed. The love was always there. I want to ask you a question. 23, the number 23, what does it mean to you? The number 23. What does it mean? Are you the great class of 22? Are you the great class of 23? Yeah. Okay. And when you think of 23, do any other things come to mind? You people especially who are interested in sports. 23. Yeah. The GOAT of professional basketball. The GOAT. Right, there's another GOAT in another sport, and I'm not so sure you know this GOAT. Are any of you into tennis? Well, I'm not either, really, to tell you the truth, totally. But every now and then I watch. And the French Open was a couple of weeks ago. And a man by the name of Novak Djokovic won that tournament. It was his 23rd Grand Slam win. His 23rd. Guess what, girls? There was only one other person in tennis that achieved that. Serena Williams. It was a woman, and she came first. The men had to wait for him to come along to follow after her. Don't forget that woman. Don't forget it. Your voice is needed. It is important. No man can say what you can say. No one. Actually, no one can say what you can say. And I'll tell you why. Look at your palm. Look at your palm. Got all these lines on it, right? And should something horrible happen to you, which hope it never does, you might be identified by some of the lines in these hands and in your fingertips, right? It is, in a sense, a legal identification of who you are. Who put those lines on your hand? God. Is there another person in the universe, whoever was, whoever will be, who will have the same print? No. But the good thing about it is that God's imprint on your hand is also on your mind and on your heart. And that's the really important thing. Because how will that imprint influence you, the decisions you make, the paths you walk, the relationships you develop? How will God's imprint on your mind and on your heart influence you? I'm assuming that God's influence on your mind will lead you to learnings that will inspire in you the desire to do something good for others with that knowledge that you have. Something good. Understand what's happening to people. Reach back into your mind and try to figure out how you can help. And more importantly, reach down into your heart. What does your heart say when you see other people in need? What did your heart say when one of your classmates sat in the cafeteria and ate alone? What did your heart say? I hope it said something. I hope it said, get up, walk over to her or him, and invite him to join you, or ask if you can join him or her. This is what makes life worth living. So, I'm going to tell you a very quick story, and I'm going to get out of here quickly. Don't worry. The same man, Novak Djokovic, when he received his trophy, said, you know, when I was a child, I always dreamed of being a tennis champion. I didn't only dream it, I always was visualizing it. How I would get better, how my forehand would improve. How will I get better? And he said, I always did that all my life. And what I was doing, but I wasn't realizing it, I was creating my future. You will be creating your future. And hopefully you will do it in a very serious way, understanding what it means to have God's imprint on your mind and on your heart. I love that story. It has a lot of meaning for me. And I think it does for you too. You started creating your story a long time ago. But I want to say this to you, and I hope parents understand what I mean. When you go to high school, I want you to know that it's going to be what you make it. What you make it. How you embrace the learning presented to you. How you reach out to others. How you truly, fully engage in the life that's in that school. And you want to know something else? Nobody else can do that for you. Nobody. It is all up to you. And it will be what you make it, and as a result of that, you will be what you make it. That's reality. So I'm very, first of all, I cannot tell you how impressed I am with all of this. I could have just been crying in that bench, but Mrs. Adubato wouldn't let me. It is very moving to see you. It is very moving to understand the achievements that you have gained. It is very, very moving to me. I genuinely mean that. I care. I'm glad. I don't know you, but we are so happy at St. Vincent's to be in partnership with RTA. It's a partnership based on our deep love for young people and our deep belief in what they are capable of doing, and our deep desire to walk with them on those paths where they're becoming more and more and more who God made them to be, the best person God made them to be. So I began by saying, so I do want to congratulate you from the bottom of my heart. I think it's great. It's awesome. What you've accomplished is great. And I believe that you'll go on and you'll keep accomplishing. Have hope. We all have hope in you. But you need to have a very deep hope in yourself. A deep hope in the God who walks with you. Every day, every step, every direction you take, good, bad, indifferent, God is there. And so for me, it is good that we are here. Here, in this space, that reminds you, I hope, that God, cares about you more than any of us could ever do. And I pray that you will never, ever, ever forget that God is walking with you through every single thing you do. And remember this sacred space. You are so blessed to be able to end one major part of your life in a sacred space where God is so present in a very special way. God bless you. Congratulations. God bless everyone here. God bless your families. And thanks very much for this opportunity, because I have always had such deep respect for Robert Treat Academy and for its founder and for the family.
One more time for Sister June Favada. In just a couple minutes, you can hear from our co-valedictorians, but right now we have another special guest to make a very important special presentation. You met and heard from Senator Ruiz before, but another role model, another leader in this community who cares deeply about the young men and women at the Robert Treat Academy and all the young men and women in this community is our North Ward councilman, who is here to present two very special scholarships. Put your hands together for the North Ward councilman, Aníbal Ramos.
Good morning, everyone. It's always a privilege and honor to be here at the Robert Treat Academy's graduation ceremony. To Cardinal Tobin, Father Jason, Father Bismarck, thank you for allowing us to host this wonderful celebration here at this incredible basilica. Today, I'm here for a very simple purpose, and that's really to honor two of today's graduates. About 20 years ago, our office set up a civic association with the purpose of supporting residents of the North Ward in a variety of different ways. And one of the primary missions of our civic association is really to raise money so that we can invest in our young people throughout the city of Newark. And the North Ward is blessed to have some of the very best K to 8 schools in the whole city of Newark. And we're especially proud every single year to honor graduates from the Robert Treat Academy, because to me, the Robert Treat Academy has been a pioneer in providing excellent educational options for parents, for young people throughout the city of Newark. And since we started our scholarship program, ironically, about 70% of our recipients have been young women. And today, we're honored to honor two young men from this graduating class who both will be attending St. Benedict's Prep. So as I announce your name, please stand up and be recognized for today's very special distinction. One of our honorees today is Michael Legere Hill. And the second honoree is Emmanuel Batista. Congratulations to both of these scholarship recipients. And Sammy has a big check, which you can't take to the bank and deposit, okay? You gotta wait for the weird one.
Councilman, would you take a picture? Councilman, come here and take a picture. Now, they did not know about this. What a great surprise, not just for you, but for your parents. That deserves a great round of applause. And thank you, Councilman Aníbal Ramos. Imagine walking around Newark with that big check. So, I said you were going to meet our co-valedictorians. Sammy's got it. So this is pretty amazing. Co-valedictorians. Tyler Shea Corrales. And Lucas Delana. Now get this, both Tyler and Lucas are graduating with a great point average, 4.52. Now Tyler is a member of the National Junior Honor Society and participates in the Robert Treat Academy Student Council. Tyler is also a recipient of the Stephen N. Adubato Senior Founders Award for overall excellence. Tyler trains hard, plays baseball during his quote-unquote free time. He's on a baseball travel team and dreams of one day becoming a Major League Baseball player. Now Tyler will be attending Del Barton. I can't believe we had the Del Barton and the Seton Hall Prep people sitting together. That'll work out. And at Del Barton, Tyler plans to study computer science and excel as a student athlete. Put your hands together for Tyler. Now, let me tell you about our co-valedictorian, about Lucas Delana, also a member of the Student Council, Cinema Club, Drama Club, and outside of school, Lucas volunteers as an altar server, spends his summer at NJIT's summer academic program. As our second valedictorian, Lucas has won first place in a jiu-jitsu competition, third place plaque in a poem or for a poem that he wrote on Law Day in a writing competition. Lucas spends his quote-unquote, again, free time reading, playing video games, and watching basketball at Seton Hall Prep. Let's put your hands together for Seton Hall Prep. We have a special affinity for the Prep. Sorry, you know. Our boys went there. At Seton Hall Prep, Lucas will continue playing basketball, working on engineering. He plans to pursue a career in aeronautical engineering. I can't even say it, much less conceive of it. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2023, co-valedictorians, Tyler Shea Corrales and Lucas Delana.
Took a second. Good morning, everyone. My name is Tyler Shea Corrales. It's still going to take me another second, sorry. And I am proud to stand in front of you today as one of our 2023 co-valedictorians. I would like to begin by giving a warm welcome to our honored guests, administration, staff, families, and of course, our very own class of 2023. Thank you to all of the staff and administration for the work you do to make everything that happens at RTA possible. You are the backbone of this entire community, and we cannot thank you all enough. Before I continue, I want to congratulate everyone sitting behind me today. Our class has been a pleasure to spend the last 9 years of my life with, and I cannot express that enough. Even though it hasn't always been smooth, we found a way to keep persevering, and it got us to where we are today. When faced with brand new challenges such as COVID and lockdown, we were able to power through and continue striving towards our best. Through all of this, there was one group of people that I could count on, and that was you guys. You all made even the toughest times enjoyable, giving me some of the best memories that I have to this day. Thank you. Finally, I would like to thank my family. We all know that my schedule, split between baseball and academics, has been no joke. Without all of you to help and be there to chauffeur me around, there's no way that I could have ever dreamt of keeping up with both. On a more serious note, you all have honestly taught me things that I would have never learned, even going to a great school like RTA. And this has prepared me, more than anything, for the challenges that I have faced. Even when I failed and failed and failed, you all were always there to help me learn from it. Thank you. As for me, I still remember the day 9 years ago when my dad came home with the news that I would be joining the kindergarten class at Robert Reed Academy after being on the waiting list for the first 2 weeks of August. I remember the excitement on both of my parents' faces and their talks of the conversation that they had with Big Steve on the day of the lottery. I may have been clueless to why they felt this way at the time, but I think I got a clue or two over the years. Everyone who attends RTA eventually figures out how lucky we truly are to be here. Though I would love to stay in this place forever, we all have to move on. And I am proud to say that I will be doing so at Del Barn High School as a Green Wave. Now let me pass it on to the slightly less fortunate Mr. Cian Hall Prep himself, my co-valedictorian, Lucas Delano.
Thank you, Tyler. Again, my name is Lucas Delano, and I will attend the far superior high school, Cian Hall Prep. Go Pirates! And thank you again, everyone, and attendance for coming here today to watch us finish this tremendous chapter in our lives. I'm so proud to be standing here today. The foundation, support, and overall guidance you gave me at Robert Reed Academy built me up to where I am today. I am so grateful to Big Steve for founding this exceptional school for past, present, and future students to attend and receive a wonderful education, earning a family at RTA for life. I would like to acknowledge my family and thank them because they not only lit a lamp for me in my darkest moments, but pushed me to my limits, past where I was comfortable. My parents, even when we don't see eye to eye, always find it in themselves to love me for who I am and who they believe I will be. Without their dedication to raising me into the young man I've become, I don't think I would have gotten this far. Last, but certainly not least, I would love to thank my classmates. Each of you in the years we have known each other has lifted me up at one point, whether for strength, endurance, or to push higher than my limits. We crawled and ran, sank and flew, cried and laughed, but we all did it together. I can proudly call all of you my friends and companions. Throughout my time at RTA, I have learned the importance of determination and never doubting yourself in the face of failure. I don't believe I have ever felt more distance from my peers and teachers than when we hit quarantine. Learning from behind a screen made me feel alone and as if I lost my voice, but I persevered and never gave up when it came to communicating and studying. I made it through to show that perseverance and determination pay off when you have big goals in mind. The future is here, class of 2023. All the classes, quizzes, tests, and study sessions have brought us here to this very moment. The tireless nights and countless essays have led us to where we are at this very moment. I wish you all the best of luck to the futures you all wish to have. Let us celebrate this milestone and be proud of the goals we have already accomplished. And never forget the words and teachings of our teachers, as they will only guide you into the right direction. Let go of your failures and look forward to the bright future ahead. Best of luck to you all, and never forget that RTA is always a safe place to come back and visit family.
Our co-valedictorians deserve a much better round of applause than that. So Tyler and Lucas. Paul. You know, listening to Lucas make mention of the pandemic, I know we don't want to go back and think about that, but for those of us parents who tried to imagine, I mean, it was tough for us, but I can't even comprehend for our children what it was like to be isolated, to be separated, to be home, to wear a mask constantly. Academically, that's one thing. Learning loss is real. I'm not here to make a speech, but the emotional, psychological, and the other issues that our young people faced and still face is real. So to see the graduates today, it's particularly exciting. But let's not forget that this class has experienced something, and others in the future will have experienced something at a very young age that all of us as kids, no matter what we faced growing up here in Newark or wherever, couldn't even comprehend. So in that spirit, Paul, can you take care of this? This is a very special presentation with the Panera family, with Jim and Joan. And I'd like you to please join us so we can make this very special presentation.
Yes, thank you, Stephen, and well said. You know, this moment every year, I'm reminded as I look out, I stand up here and I look out of how special this all is. And for those of you wondering if Mr. Trillo cries, he cries. He cries like a baby. It's usually because of like the Mets and the Jets, but I can confirm that, you know, that he does cry. At this moment, I would like to bring up two very special people. You know, the tragic loss of their son, Jamie, an RTA teacher, back in December of 2014, brought us together as friends. The work since then that has been completed in establishing the James A. Panera Foundation and this scholarship fund has brought us together as family. Please help me welcome Joan and Jim Panera.
Thank you, Paul. Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the James A. Panera Third Foundation, my husband Jim and I would like to thank the Board of Trustees, Principals Trillo and Parada, teachers and staff for inviting us to participate in this joyous occasion. We're so pleased to celebrate the class of 2023's graduation with all of you. As Paul mentioned, the James A. Panera III Award is given in memory of our son, who was a member of the Robert Treat Academy faculty from August 2014 until his untimely death in December of that same year. This year, we received a large number of applications for the award, and we have a finite pool of money to distribute. So we really scrutinized the applications very carefully before making some very difficult decisions. However, the message that came through in many of the essays is that the COVID-19 pandemic hit this particular class, very hard during their fifth and sixth grades. While each student of the class of 23 has a unique story about their time in their lives, it is clear to me that they didn't allow an unprecedented global situation to hold them back. Instead, they each persevered in completing their schoolwork in a remote environment, some of them also dealing with personal loss, and all of them missing the contact they had with their teachers and classmates. When they were finally able to return to the Robert Treat Academy and get back to some semblance of their normal school life, they worked through what it took to rekindle friendships and rejoin a wonderful community within the school and grow into who they are today. Class of 2023, you are certainly ready to greet the new challenges of high school that await you, and we congratulate each of you on your achievements and hard work that brought you here today. We encourage all of you to embark on your high school careers with a confident and positive attitude so that you can reap all the benefits of your continued education. Today, we are very pleased to present the James A. Panera III Award to 7 recipients. The first is Jacob Dismukes, who is attending St. Peter's Prep. Donaldson. This time I'm going to announce the school first because no one can hear it. So everybody's clapping. So he'll be attending St. Peter's Prep. Matthew Duffy.
They don't know this.
No, this is a surprise. This is a surprise. So all you parents are surprised too. So she'll be attending Miss Porter School, Nyla Van Dyke. Attending Immaculate Conception High School, Jayani Nieves. She'll be attending Oak Knoll School, Emanuela Okudishi. Is going to be attending La Cordera Academy, Veronica Velasquez.
Let's thank Joan and Jim Panera. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you so much to the Panera family. It means a lot to us. I know it means a lot to you guys as well. One more time, we're gonna hear from our Robert Reed Academy chorus. This time we have solos by Michaela Amador, Faith Garay, Carolise Espinal-Volquez, Jerem Cuellar, Ronnie Vasquez, and Emily Pingham, as the chorus will be performing This Is Me from the popular movie The Greatest Showman by Benj Pasak and Justin Paul. Ladies and gentlemen, the Robert Reed Academy Chorus. Thank you.
That was awesome. The Robert Treat Academy Chorus. Where is Alexander Cruz? Alexander, where are you? Can't see you past the... Come on down here, and Angel Fuentes. Angel, come on down. So there's a special presentation that you have, I believe. So Alexander and Angel are going to be presenting flowers to the founding mother. Ma, you got all dressed up for this. The founding mother of the Robert Treat Academy, Fran Adubato. Let's hear it for Fran. There you are, Mom. And to the previous principal of the Robert, you heard Sister June say the young Steve Adubato, the considerably older sister of mine, Teresa Adubato, who is the previous principal of the Robert Treat Academy. Michelle, is that all right? I gave her. No, you matter, Michelle, just not today. It's okay. But help me on this. Principal Cho, come on. Is it a fact that this year, the class of 2023 is dedicating the Ring of Resilience, no idea what that is, the Ring of Resilience to Fran Adubato, which is going to be displayed in the lobby of the Stephen N. Adubato campus, is that right? Now, what is this, the Ring of Resilience, a short version, what is it? Go ahead.
It's painted orange.
Orange. That's Fran's favorite color is orange. Go ahead.
She came over. She saw it yesterday.
Yes. She approved it?
She approved.
Yes.
And we said Steve would probably be jealous. We probably want his name on it.
And you did not do that?
No.
This is all from my mother, Fran Adubato. The Ring of Resilience. That's right, Ma. Resilience. So that's, we're going to do the, who's ready by a round of applause to see our graduates receive their diplomas? So our board president of the Robert Treat Academy, let's hear for Robert Dutour. Come on up, Bob. Bob's going to be joined by Mr. Trillo, Mr. Parada, to certify our graduates. Mr. Parada, please read the names of all of our graduates.
First of all, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, I want to congratulate the class of 2023, their families, teachers, and school administrators. I'd also like to recognize another member of the board who's here with us today, Galen Johnson. Stand up, Galen. And I want to thank Mr. Trillo and Mr. Parada on behalf of the board for their leadership during the past academic year. Now we'll start the process to award these diplomas. By the power vested in us by the Board of Trustees of the Robert Treat Academy Charter School, and in accordance with the laws and regulations of the state of New Jersey, we declare that these students have met all the requirements for graduation, and therefore now we authorize that the class of 2023 receive their diplomas. Mr. Trillo and Mr. Parada, please proceed.
Well, you sound ready. I think the bigger question is, are they ready? Boys and girls of the graduating class of 2023, are you ready? Let's go.
All right, here we go. Graduating with honors, Michaela Amador. Jasmine Baskerville.
Graduating with high honors, Emmanuel Batista.
Graduating with honors, Michael Book. Yamil Brooks. Carlos Cabrera. Matthew Caguana Peralta.
Graduating with high honors, Tyler Shea Corrales.
Kaylee B. Crawford. Alexander Cruz. Jerem Cuellar. Graduating with high honors, Dennis Kambikas. Graduating with high honors, Willie Kambikas.
Graduating with high honors, Lucas Delana.
Graduating with honors, Leah De Leon. Graduating with high honors, Jacob Dismukes. Graduating with honors, Matthew Duffy. Graduating with high honors, Carolise Espinal Volquez. Graduating with honors, Luis Familia. Graduating with high honors, Nicole Frias Mina. Graduating with honors, Angel Fuentes.
Graduating with honors, Michael Gallardo Montano.
Graduating with honors, Faith Garay. Graduating with high honors, Tristan Gonzalez. Graduating with honors, Mia Valentina Guerrero.
Miracle Hamilton Gillis. Graduating with honors, Adrian Holliger. Graduating with high honors, Ian Hilton. Graduating with high honors, India Hilton. Graduating with honors, Sarah Inway. Graduating with high honors, Trayvon Jackson. Graduating with honors, Preston Joseph.
Michael Legere Hill. Patrick Ligwichuska. Graduating with high honors, Yaritza Menjavar. Xavier Morales. Graduating with high honors, Amani Mosley. Graduating with high honors, Akash Myri. Jayani Nieves.
Graduating with high honors, Emanuela Ukudishu.
That gave us the pause we needed. That's good. Graduating with high honors, Ariana Ortega. Emily Paladines. Graduating with high honors, Emily Pena. Deshali Ramirez.
Juan David Ramos. Graduating with high honors, Ethan Roundtree. Graduating with high honors, Zuri Ruffin.
Sean Sanders. Randy Sarango Lopez.
Graduating with honors, Timothy Simmons. Graduating with high honors, Mariam Segunle.
Ariel Soto. Graduating with high honors, Jordan Soto.
Graduating with honors, Aviana Tuck.
Brandon Tercios.
Graduating with honors, Bella Usosike.
Graduating with honors, Nyla Van Dyke.
Ronnie Vasquez.
Michaela Vega. Graduating with honors, Veronica Velasquez. Graduating with honors, Santiago Villar Ortiz.
Michael Warwick.
Michaela Wheeler. Graduating with honors, Alana Zarati. Graduating with honors, Kaylee Zarati. And graduating with high honors, Janias Zuniga. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2023. All right, before we do the last part, and the last part is makes it official, but one last time we're gonna make you sing the alma mater. So, rise, graduates. Before the organist plays, you have one last task. Turn your tassels from your left to your right. All right, guys, God bless and Godspeed. Thank you, everyone, for coming out today. Support them forever.